Episodic memory is your memory for episodes in your life, so very specific autobiographical moments. It's always been a mystery why it is that children who are in their first 2 years of life are learning a lot about the world. They are learning the word banana, for instance. And yet we don't remember events from our lives before the age of two. So I wanted to explain both why we seem to forget all of the events of our lives between zero and two, despite the fact that we're learning, as I said, words and lots of facts about the world, and then why between the age of two and six, our memories are, you know, more fragmentary than they later will be.
And look, there are all these containers. Do you want to open them? And let's look and see if any of them have any toys inside. Which one do you want to open first?
So we came up with this procedure where kids go to two different rooms with two different experimenters, and those rooms look a bit different, they're described differently. One has clouds on the door, one has rainbows on the door. But in those rooms there are four containers, the same four containers in the one room as in the other room. But the containers are also arranged differently. So there's many cues where the child knows, okay, now I'm in this room, now I'm in that room. And they also are shown that there's a specific toy in one of the containers. Let's say it's a turquoise shopping bag in one of the rooms. And the other three containers contain nothing. So the question is whether they remember which is the good bag in the cloud room and which is the good bag in the rainbow room. The very youngest children couldn't remember which container contained the toy, even when we cued them in a very, very supportive way, which is we gave them part of the toy. So if you give, you know, those bubble juice things where you use a wand and you blow bubbles. If you give them the wand and you say, where's the bubble juice? They don't know. Now, suppose you don't give them the bubble wand. Now it's a little harder. Now the two-year-olds can't do it. And in fact, the three-year-olds really can't do it. And the four-year-olds get a little bit better. And we documented a gradual progression. It's not really till the age of five that children top this out.
Can you remember where a toy was in here? Was it there? Let's see. Oh my goodness, there they are.
The part of everyday life that it relates to is that it's actually very important to social interaction to be able to remember these kinds of experiences. So, for instance, if your mother wants to know about your day in school, it's important to her that you say whether or not you played with your friend Penny, whether or not you did well on your spelling test. You know, those kinds of things. And in fact, your parents are probably going to be a little dismayed if you can't remember if Penny was in school today, or you don't answer about did you like your peanut butter sandwich and these kinds of things. So it is very important to coordinating our social experience to be able to have episodic memory.